right now on Sunrise. A busy week of travel ahead for the holiday, despite warnings not to.
And I know it's hard. We're tired and we miss our families and our friends, but this is one year to make a sacrifice to keep our loved ones healthy.
But for those who do decide to travel this holiday season, I'm breaking down what you should expect to see at the airport and what airport officials are doing to keep you safe.
And new hope in the fight against the coronavirus. A new vaccine looking for approval and its effectiveness that has some people worried.
Get ready for a cold start. I'm looking at current temperatures along with the wind chill and the chance for rain and snow in the 7 day.
Culture, community, and a fresh cut. How Gideon's Barbershop is opening up meaningful conversations in the styling chair.
A heartbreaking loss for the Vikings. What this means for their playoff hopes as Sunrisers sound off this morning.
It's Monday, November 23rd. Care 11 Sunrise starts now.
Good morning. It's time to take the turkey out of the freezer. That's right. Get the bird out of the deep freeze. The USDA says depending on the weight, if you want it thawed by Thursday, it needs to be in the fridge by today. That will solve a lot of problems.
Yeah. So with a lot of people staying home for the holidays, there will be more first timers on turkey duty. And they need your help, Sunrisers. We want to know your cooking tips for that perfect Thanksgiving Day turkey. Text them to us, 763-797-7215. Already got some good ones on Twitter.
Yeah, number one tip, takeout.
Yeah.
There you go.
You don't have to worry about it at all. I've never made a turkey.
Yeah, I was getting ready to say, if it needs to be in the fridge today, I need to get on it. But yeah. I think turkey legs will probably just be better, nice and quick.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Get the legs separate, you know?
Especially if you're having a smaller Thanksgiving, which many are.
Yeah. All right, well, we do have some rain and snow in the forecast, but that isn't until tomorrow morning this time. For now, we're just in the cold. It's the 20s, the low 20s, and right, it feels actually like 24, so winds actually backed off a bit and relaxed just a hair, but still dressed for the wind chill this morning. You'll see the wind chill value of about 30 later this afternoon. Highs today will be in the mid to upper 30s with sun.
And your morning commute is off to a pretty good start, but we are keeping an eye on a crash here near 35E between there and Rice Street near Little Canada. So heads up if that is part of your commute.
All right, thanks for that, Kaya. Happening today, a big announcement coming from Governor Walz. It has to do with dialing back and the technology to help fight the spread of coronavirus. We'll have to wait to find out what that's all about. What we do know, it comes as Minnesotans try to figure out their Turkey Day plans. Gordon Severson is live at MSP, where this year's Thanksgiving travel season will be very different. Gordon?
Yeah, very different. MSP officials here say that they're expecting about 35 to 40% fewer holiday travelers this year. And nationwide, the TSA says about 1 million Americans flew out on Friday and another 1 million on Saturday. That's about half of what they normally see. But this should come as no surprise given the amount of new COVID cases that we're seeing, not just here in Minnesota, but also nationwide. A lot of people are deciding to just stay closer to home this Thanksgiving. Airport officials and the TSA say they're doing everything they can to keep people safe. At the TSA checkpoints, they've shut down every other lane to space people out. They've also added new touch-free ID scanners, and they're also bending the rules so that travelers can bring up to 12 ounces of hand sanitizer in their carry-on luggage. And travelers say most people, for the most part, are following the rules.
They make sure you got your mask on. They repeatedly tell
mandatory.
You, like, keep your mask on.
Yes. They definitely is sticking with the social distancing and mandatory masks unless you're eating or drinking.
The staff and everybody has been real relaxed with it. They bring a lot of cleaning supplies by like every 5 minutes. You try to doze off and they're like, you want a hand sanitizer? And I'm like, no, I'm sleeping. But everything's been very good.
Now, if you're going to be flying out later this week, here are a few tips that you should know. You're going to need to wear a mask in the terminal and also in the airplane. So it's going to be several hours straight that you're going to have to wear that mask. Also, the airport officials tell us that the busiest days are going to be on Wednesday with everyone flying out and Sunday with everyone flying back. So if you're flying on one of those 2 days, allow a little extra time. And if you haven't booked your tickets yet, try to avoid those days and save yourself some time. Back to you.
Now, always good advice. Thanks, Gordon.
Well, as we're coming off the first weekend of new restrictions in Minnesota, we want to take a closer look at the numbers. So MDH is reporting high numbers of cases and deaths over the weekend, but get this, no records. That is a good thing. More than 7,200 new cases yesterday in these blue bars right here. We are hitting above, as you can see, this two-week average at 6,000 mark per day. In deaths, MDH reported 51 more people died on Saturday, and then check this out, 40 yesterday. That record was 72, as you might remember, on Thursday. Now in Wisconsin, a bright spot there, no new deaths reported yesterday. The new cases reported were more than 3,500 yesterday, which hasn't been as high as we've seen it. But check this out. I want you to take a look at this two-week average here, because as you can see right here, it looks like it appears to be curving and it's going in the right direction. So we don't know if that means it's stabilizing or going down, but we'll be watching that two-week average in the next couple of days and the next couple of weeks to see how this Thanksgiving holiday will impact it.
But there's promising news in the fight against the coronavirus. New this morning, AstraZeneca and the University of Oxford have announced their vaccine is now 70% effective on average. It was 90% effective when participants got a half a dose of the vaccine, then a full dose 1 month later. Last week, Pfizer and Moderna said their vaccines were around 95% effective.
We are taking you live from the White House this morning, where a presidential transfer of power is moving forward despite efforts by President Trump. And here's the three things you need to know this morning. The recount in Milwaukee County is currently running behind schedule. The county clerk says the process is going slower because of objections raised by the Trump campaign's observers and attorneys. They say their administration says they want every ballot counted correctly. Pennsylvania is also seeing roadblocks as President Trump appeals an elections case. The case was initially thrown out by a judge. That judge said the Trump campaign's arguments lacked evidence and was an attempt to disenfranchise legal voters. Despite the roadblocks, President-elect Joe Biden is moving ahead with his transition. This week, the president-elect is expected to name more members of his cabinet. Reports say he will likely name his nominees for Secretary of State and Treasury Secretary.
New video coming in overnight out of Minneapolis. A box truck appears to be heavily damaged on the sidewalk near 46 and Lake Street. That's right before the Lake Street Bridge. You can see a light pole is also down. We are working to figure out what exactly happened. You'll be the first to know once we learn more. Now here's a look at today's other top stories in your morning rush. A man is dead and a woman seriously injured after a shooting in Minneapolis, and police are trying to figure out who pulled the trigger. Police say it happened near Dowling and North 6 Saturday afternoon. When police arrived, both victims had been taken to the hospital. The man later died. No arrests yet. Happening today, the Llano Lake City Council is voting on banning targeted protests in residential neighborhoods. It comes after an August protest outside the home of Minneapolis Police Union President Bob Kroll in the neighboring city of Hugo. Protesters were demanding Kroll's resignation after the death of George Floyd. A viral video showed several demonstrators beating pinata depictions of Kroll and his wife. The Loons are three games away from an MLS championship. They put the smack down on Colorado Sunday, beating the Rapids 3-0. It was scoreless till the 22nd minute when Kevin Molino came in hot, giving the Loons the lead, and they didn't look back from there. Robin Laud will score the second of the night, and Molino makes a return to seal the deal. The Loons play Sporting KC in the semis. And if you haven't noticed yet, the holiday season is upon us. Over the weekend, downtown St. Paul lit up the holiday lights in Rice Park. You'll be able to stop and see the holiday cheer for a while. The lights will be up through February. And that's your Monday Morning Rush.
Sunrise Live, we are reading through hundreds of your comments on our Facebook page about the Vikings' embarrassing loss to the helpless Cowboys. It ended their three-game win streak and put hopes of a playoff berth in jeopardy. So what went wrong? Come on, this was a game we were supposed to win. The Cowboys suck. Word of the day, I guess. Let's fast forward to the fourth quarter, where Vikings are trailing by two. Kirk Cousins fires a strike to Adam Thielen for his second score of the game. Vikings take a lead 21-16. After a quick touchdown puts the Cowboys in front, the Vikings go back to the air. Cousins drops hit right into Justin Jefferson's hands. For a 39-yard score, Vikings again taking the lead 28-24. But then there were a lot of errors on the Vikings' part, like not converting on key third downs and turnovers. But this is one that put the dagger in the coffin. 90 seconds to play. The Cowboys march down the field and Andy Dalton's hits a wide open receiver for the game winning score. And Vikings lose 31-28.
I don't think we played well enough to win today. We had our opportunities, made too many mistakes, three fumbles in the first half, lost two. We had too many penalties, weren't good in the red zone on defense today. And then, we can't get the fourth down play to win the game.
Just a heartbreaking loss today. It was hard fought. It was a back and forth game. It's one of those games, and so many NFL games are like this, but where one or two plays, makes the difference in the end.
So here we are, 4-6 with six games left in the season. So are playoffs even an option? The answer is yes. Remember, there is an expanded format this year, which means better chances for our Vikings. But losses like yesterday, they just cannot happen. So what do you think about yesterday's loss and the Vikings playoffs hope? Let us know, you guys, using that hashtag Sunrisers. We'll share more comments at 6:30.
Ooh, I don't know if my ears can take it. Some harsh comments there. But, the best way for the Vikes to make the playoffs is to have that expanded playoff format because of COVID. So hopefully they'll get in.
So yay.
I don't know.
Guy, what's our one thing weather today?
Yeah, one thing sunny and quiet, just a chilly start. Temperatures in the low 20s, and we could have a wind chill at times. Highs today will be in the mid to upper 30s.
And your one thing, traffic, is that roads are looking pretty good this morning. No major crashes to report.
Well, we're breaking down what you missed in the American Music Awards, including why Taylor Swift wasn't there to accept her Artist of the Year award in person.
Did Kanye get it for her?
No.
No? Oh, the suspense. Then a shocking rescue goes viral the moment this man saved a puppy from getting eaten by an alligator.
And haircut therapy, how this Twin Cities barbershop is giving you more than a fresh new do.